testimony and testify in the house. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord Jesus. I want to thank God for the salvation of my soul and the life of my family members. I want to thank God for healing. You know, maybe 4 years and my daughter, I don't know what happened, but then she was not feeling fine, went to hospital, even myself as well, I was very strong. But to the glory of God, we are here.
Praise
God.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I want to thank God for the salvation of my soul, the rest of my family. For a couple of months now, or weeks, I've been on the road, Delta, West, everywhere, the Davis, Oberia, or other things. And the journeys were so smooth that I think, I cannot be really a good response. And I thank God for joining my sisters in journey. And all what I went for, I'm still going for. I hope everything is, because the journey, the traveling has not stopped. Next week again, I'll be on the road. And I pray to God that we grant us many mercies. Number two, we should not take our prayers for granted, because little things that we think is not important in our life, for me, it's important. This itching of eyes, you know, has given me concern all the time. But once I place my hands on it and pray to God that I want it to stop right now, believe you me, it will stop. But maybe 2-3 weeks again it will start. But immediately I pray. If I don't pray, I say, let me do this. If I don't pray, continue itching me and, you know, without stopping. But once I place my hands on my eyes and I pray, God, I want this eyes itching to stop immediately, it will stop. So we should not, and little things like that, too many things that I take for granted, but once I pray about it, it will stop. So we should always intensify our habit of praying to God. And in my place of work, when I was away, things that happened on my behalf, you know, cost me that I said, wow, because those are the things I've been praying against. And I said, if these things will happen, I will not be there. And if they are happening, I will not meet them. And that was what happened exactly. You know, because the disaster when I left, it happened on my behalf. And I thank God I wasn't there, because that was always my prayer. So God be the glory, I was not there. Praise the Lord.
Praise God. I thank God for the salvation of my soul. Last week, I was in a location, and after the job, I was paid. Then I got home, I was so tired. So when I opened my gate, I didn't know that my boss, where I have my driving license, my 2 ATMs, my national ID card, in fact, all my documents were inside that boss. And the money I was paid was inside that bus. So I entered my house. I didn't know that the bus fell on the ground outside. So when in the morning, around 8:30, I remembered the bus. And I said, I checked, I didn't see. I went to my room, I checked, I didn't see. And people were passing the bus. Everyone was passing the bus. And when I came out, I said, let me check. Whether it was on the table or on the corridor, it was not there. The woman was standing beside the bus and was calling somebody upstairs. Hey, hello. Then I opened and collected my bus. In fact, it was as if somebody has bought a car for me, because all the documents there, if I'm to start to look for them, it will take me 1 month before I get everything. So I thank God for what he has done for me.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I want to thank God for the salvation of my soul. I want to thank God especially for my family. I'm standing in the gap for my first son, he's 17 today. I want to thank God for the blessings he has bestowed on my family and all the good things he's done within the spirit. Thank you, Jesus.
Let's say for some answers, let's thank God for his faithfulness in their lives, showing up as the Almighty God,
Let's cover this testimony with the blood of Jesus. And none shall return as prayer requests. My greater testimony, God will empower them to testify. And those of us that have listened to this, great things God will do in our lives. I'll wait for testimony in Jesus' name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Shall we please be on our feet as we begin to appreciate the Lord? Let's thank Him for His faithfulness. Let's give Him all the praise. Him alone is worthy to be praised. Thank you, Father. Come to say, Father.
Thank you.
For your faithfulness.
For your faithfulness.
And your mercy in my life and family. Let's appreciate the Lord for His faithfulness and His mercy in our lives, in our families, in His church, in this nation. Father, we give you all the glory, all honor, all adoration. Blessed be your holy name. Thank you, Almighty God. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, as this week is coming to an end, every blessing, every miracle, every victory that was still outstanding, Father, direct them to come to my life, into my family, into my business, my career, the works of my hand, my finances, my health, into my home, into my accounts, in the name of Jesus. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Eternal God, we thank you. Thank you for answered prayers. As we continue, let your presence continue with us. Let the light in your word shine into our hearts. In all, let your name alone be glorified. Let your counsel alone stand, and let your perfect will be done. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Please be seated in the presence of the Lord. I want to appreciate God for another privilege. Today, as we know, is the time for is the Holy Ghost early favor hour. But briefly, I just want to talk about EFE, Empowerment for Exploits. Daniel 11, 32, please. Daniel 11, 32 says, the latter part says, let's read from it. Say, and such as do wickedly against the covenant shall be corrupt by flatteries. But the people that do know their God shall be strong and do what?
Exploit.
This is God's expectation concerning all His children. Doing exploits. In the book of Matthew 5, 14 to 16, when it says, we should be the light of the world. He's saying, don't just be docile. Go forth, let them know my spirit is in you. Let them know I have empowered you. Let them know you are a source, a channel of blessing. You know, when I was thinking about the word exploit, I said, doing great feats, doing something remarkable, but I now went into the book of 1 Corinthians 2:9. Because we need to have this understanding what God is saying. 1 Corinthians 2:9. 9 and 10. It says, as it is written, I have not seen, nor neither has entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for them that love Him. 10 please. But God has revealed them unto us by what? By His Spirit. For the Spirit searcheth all things, yea, the deep things of God. Brethren, without the Holy Spirit, without us having the empowerment by the Holy Spirit, we cannot do anything. Even our Lord Jesus Christ, in the book of Acts 10, 38, it said, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with what? With power and what? The Holy Ghost. The next it says, and He went about doing what? Doing good. Healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. Praise the Lord. Inasmuch as we are ready for God, the power is there. Is it the power God has given to us? No man, no government can withstand it. But we as children of God, we are lying docile. Today, that fire will be rekindled in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Please give me Zechariah 4:6. As we will soon be praying, Zechariah 4:6 says, not by power, not by might. Then he answered and spoke unto him, saying, this is the word of the Lord unto Zerubbabel, saying, not by might, nor by power, But by my spirit said the Lord of hosts. 10. Sorry, please, 7. Give me 7, the next verse. Say, who art thou, O great man, before Zerubbabel? Thou shalt become what? A plain, and it shall bring forth the headstone. Therefore, we shall be crying, grace, grace unto thee. So which means we are supposed to make mountains become plain. We are supposed to speak to situations, and situations will be gone. We are supposed to lay our hands upon the sick, and they will be healed. We are supposed to raise the dead. Brethren, it's not only pastors. It's not only general overseer that raised the dead. See, every child of God, that you have the Holy Spirit in you. The Spirit that raised Christ, according to Romans 8, is the same Spirit that is in us. We are supposed to win souls for Him. But today, the fire will be rekindled in Jesus' name. Amen. I want us to rise to our feet. Because in as much as the power has been given to us, what are we doing with it? They're going to say, Holy Spirit, help my infirmity this morning. Give me divine utterance or divine empowerment to begin to do exploits in every area of my life. In the name of Jesus, let's open our mouths as we pray in the Spirit.
Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Let's be-